I'm Libby Page, the author of The Lido, and this is my new book, The 24-Hour Cafe. It's set in Stella's All Night Cafe and tells the story of friends and waitresses, Hannah and Mona, who both waitress there but dream of more in life. It's also the story of all the characters who come in throughout the day and night and those moments in life that can really change the direction of our lives. It's about friendship and community, and I hope you enjoy it. And I'm here in Waterstones Piccadilly and want to talk to you about three of my favourite books. So the first one that I want to tell you about is The Music Shop by Rachel Joyce. Now, I absolutely love Rachel Joyce's writing. It's so descriptive, so poignant, really funny at times, but can be really heartbreaking too. So this story, as the title suggests, is set in a music shop. So Frank owns this amazing record shop and has a real passion about music, but also about his customers. He's really brilliant at pairing people up with the exact record for them, which I really love the idea of. I think similarly to bookshops, you know, music can be so important to us at different moments in our life. He then meets a mysterious woman in a green coat, and the story really follows their friendship as well as the characters that centre around the music shop. And I just loved it. I loved the characters in it, and loved the descriptions of music as well. So for my second choice, I have picked When God Was a Rabbit by Sarah Winman. This is probably my favourite book of all time. It's very difficult to pick, but I think if put on the spot, I would choose this. I love all of Sarah Winman's books, so A Year of Marvelous Ways and Tin Man as well. But this is her first and the one where I really fell in love with her writing. She's such a beautiful writer, has that kind of perfect turn of phrase. And actually, it's her writing that really inspired me to want to write my book. I heard her speak at Hay on Wye Festival, and she just spoke so passionately about storytelling and writing that it inspired me to finally start writing my own novel. So this will always have a very special place in my heart. So my final choice is a non-fiction book that actually helped to inspire my latest novel. It's called Londoners, and it's a really amazing set of interviews with all sorts of different people in London, people arriving in London, people leaving London. You've got a taxi driver, the woman who does the voiceover for all of the underground and bus service, and it just gives such an amazing depiction of the city and all the lives there. And that's something that I really wanted to cover in my new novel as well, just this sense of people's lives coming up against each other and really the breadth of people that you get within a city. So this is just absolutely fascinating in terms of finding more about people and their stories.